Heavenly Father, we are grateful to you because you have started a good thing in us, and we know you take each session to add something more to what you have done, so that the full picture of what you have in mind might be eventually realized.
Baba wa tin be ni orun adupe lowo yin fun orire te ti bere ninu aye wa na a n gbadura fe lo gbogbo isodi abala kokan eto ta n se ye lati se ase pe aworan yin ninu aye eni kokan wa loruko
Jesus. We are grateful to you for preserving the letter of Paul to Timothy in the Bible.
Adupe lowo yin be se pa letter Timothy Paul to Timothy
has been exposing to us the relevance of those words, even though they were written almost 2,000 years ago, still relevant to our situation today.
We're
praying, dear Lord, as we look today at the long line of contenders for the faith, help us to come to a point when we also join that pedigree, that family of contenders for the faith. And as we look at the long line of the corruptors of the faith, help us, Lord, to pray and to determine, not for a second, not for a minute, ever to join such a group. We are praying, dear Lord, give liberty to your word and give attention in our hearts so that we will profit thereby. Thank you for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. Yesterday we started the special series in this workers' retreat. We have chosen 2 Timothy and just a chapter in that book for our study this time. And the Lord has led to choose that because of the relevance it bears to us today. I told you yesterday it's a chapter on men. Men and women. And it tells us about different kinds of men. I told you that 4 times you find that word men put at strategic point all through that chapter. In verse 2, the beginning, we see men. In verse 8, we see men of corrupt minds. And verse 8 is the median verse of that chapter. Now we see in verse 13, evil men. And at the tail end, verse 17, we see the man, or if you like, the man of God. And we have seen the reason why Paul had to do that. It's that if you are going to lead men, you must be a kind of man yourself. Then also you must know men. Because if you don't know men, you cannot lead men to God. You see that there are different kinds of men. There are carnal men in the church. And Paul told Timothy about that. Men who are filled with self. And we saw the various manifestations of self in those men. And the Lord made us to see the need for us to pray and pray out self out of our lives. And then Paul told Timothy, there are also corrupt men, men outside the church. And if you are going to help those men, you need to know the kind of men they are. so that your ministry to them can profit them and bring them unto God. And then Paul spoke about cleansed men, consecrated men, who are like bridges that link the Almighty God with the sinful man. Let me just add this. I didn't tell you this yesterday, but let me add to you that the strength of a bridge is dependent upon the purpose to which it's going to be put. These cleansed men, these consecrated men, if they are bridges that link God with man, they bring God to man in prayer and they bring, in preaching, and they bring man to God in prayer. And if they are going to do that, the preparation you make in your life as a
breeze
will determine the use to which God will put you. There are some bridges that will make trailers to pass on top of them, long vehicles pass on top of them, and other small vehicles pass on top of them. There are other bridges because they are not as strong. They don't allow some vehicles to go that are beyond a particular weight to enter into that place. There are other bridges. The type you see in some village settings, they just take one small plank like this and they put it on that side and put it on this side. And when you are walking on it, the thing will be, you know, going up and down. As if you will jump, you will land inside the water. Common sense will tell you very quickly. If I have motorcycle, I shouldn't take it on this kind of bridge. If I have a car, the smallest car, if I take it on this bridge, it's going to break. There are some delicate believers like that. They are not strong. The bridge that they are, although they are a bridge, but the Almighty God knows there are some things I cannot use these people for because this one is too delicate. It can break at any time. My prayer for you, that you be a strong bridge for God.
But
anything and anybody can just climb through you and get onto God. And you know, the stronger the bridge is, the more attention the government pays to it. Because they know it's important. They know if that bridge, for example, in Lagos, if you take the third mainland
bridge,
that's the longest bridge that links the Lagos mainland with the Lagos island. It's more than 11 kilometers long. And now, the government pays attention to that. Because the government knows any problem on that bridge, a lot of people, a lot of vehicles at any moment pass on that bridge. If it breaks, many lives can be lost. So they don't neglect it the way they neglect the one that is close to us here. Because you see that one is so small, and who cares? If it breaks, let it break. If you are a bridge for God, you know God takes care of your life. Oh, he says, touch not my anointing. Put a fear in your life that Satan sees and he fears you. The devil and all those unclean people, they see that sign. They say, this one is not like those other people. Because you are a bridge for God. I pray for you once again that you will be a strong bridge. And the Lord told us yesterday about the problem of deceptive men and pretending temptresses in the church. And of course the Lord has to tell us that we, who are mindful of heaven, we withdraw from such people. What that means is that we are praying for them. We are preaching to them. But in lifestyle, we withdraw from them. We don't live the way they live.
Now,
as Paul told Timothy all that, Timothy was concentrating on the inner, internal, the inside of the church. And he was focusing on these other men that are, you know, giving problem in the church. And now Paul got to a point. And he starts the next verse, he says, now. You see, when we study Bible, take note of words. The reason we stopped the first study at verse 7 is because of that first word in verse 8, now. You know, when you are talking to someone, when you are talking and you are talking, and then you say, now. If you want to say something different now, or you want to draw another conclusion different from the one you were talking about before, and Paul was now going to tell Timothy about another set of problems of the last days. That's why we are looking today at the contenders and the corrupters of the gospel. Let's look at it now. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 8. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 8. It says, now as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith, but they shall proceed no further. For their folly shall be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long suffering, charity, patience, persecutions, afflictions which came unto me at Antioch, at Iconium, at Lystra, what persecutions I endured, but out of them all the Lord delivered me, yea. And all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
Àwọn ènìyàn tí inú wọn bàjẹ́ díbàjẹ́ àwọn ẹni ìtanù ní ti ọ̀ràn ìgbàgbọ́ ṣùgbọ́n wọn kì yóò lọ síwájú jù bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ nítorí wèrè wọn yóò fara hàn fún gbogbo ènìyàn gẹ́gẹ́ bí wọ́n ti yọrí sí ṣùgbọ́n ìwọ ti mọ ẹ̀kọ́ mi ìgbésí ayé mi ìpinnu ìgbàgbọ́ ìpamọ́ra ìfẹ́ ni sùúrù inú ni bí ni ìyà àwọn tí ó dé bá mi ní Antioku àti ní Koníoni àti ní Nisra àti inú ni bí ni tí mo farada Olúwa sì gbà mí kúrò nínú gbogbo wọn nítòótọ́. Gbogbo àwọn tí ó fẹ́ máa gbégbé ìwà bí Ọlọ́run nínú Kristi Jésù yóò farada nínú ibi ni. Ṣùgbọ́n àwọn èèyàn búburú àti àwọn ẹlẹ̀tàn yóò máa gbilẹ̀ síwájú sí. Wọ́n máa tanni jẹ, a ó sì máa tàn wọ́n jẹ.
The gospel is the power of God unto salvation.
Ìrere jẹ́ agbára Ọlọ́run sí ìgbàlà.
But it is also, listen, it is also the watershed of human nature, human character.
Ẹ̀ta bá tún wo lọ́nà mìíràn, ó jẹ́ ibi tí tó ń fi ìgbésí ayé ìwà àwọn ọmọ ènìyàn tó ń fi hàn.
What is a watershed?
Kí la ń pè ní
watershed? A watershed is like a dividing line between two conditions.
Tá a bá sọ nípa ohun tí a dárúkọ ni, ó jẹ́ nǹkan tó jẹ́ bí ààlà láàrin ìpele méjì.
Picture in your mind.
Káwo àwòrán
kan. A high mountain.
Sàbárí òkè.
And look at the peak of that high mountain.
Ẹ wo orí òkè téńtélé yẹn lórí òkè
náà. When if it was possible for you.
Ká ló ṣeé ṣe fún ọ.
To climb to the top of that mountain.
Láti gun orí òkè yẹn lọ.
With a bucket of water.
Láti pẹ̀lú ìwé kọ́lọ̀bù omi.
And you pour the bucket of water right on the center of the top of that mountain.
Bó bá da omi yẹn sí àárín gbùngbùn lórí òkè náà.
And the water begins to flow down.
Omi yẹn bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ṣe wá sílẹ̀.
You will observe something.
Ó ṣàkíyèsí ohun kan.
Some of the water will flow this direction down.
Díẹ̀ lára omi yẹn yóò sàn sápá àlàáfíà báyìí.
Some other will flow this other side down.
Àwọn kan yóò sàn lọ sílẹ̀ lápá ọ̀tún.
That's what we call a watershed.
Ohun tá à ń pè ní ibi tá à ń gbọ omi sí nìyẹn.
The gospel is not only the power of God unto salvation, it is also the watershed of human nature.
ìrere kì í kàn ṣe kó jẹ́ agbá ọlọ́run kìkì sí fún ìgbàlà nìkan ó jẹ́ ibi tí a ń gba omi sí náà fún ẹ̀dá ènìyàn.
Once the gospel comes to you,
tí ìrere bá ti tọ̀ ọ́ wálẹ̀ kan,
it never leaves you neutral.
Kì í fi ọ́ sílẹ̀ sí ipò tó wà lágbède méjì.
One,
àkọ́kọ́,
you either receive it. Or else you refuse it. You cannot be neutral.
So ba gbo irere yala ko gba tabi ko ko o le wa lagbede meji.
Not only that. When you receive it,
so ba gba,
then you become a contender for it. Or else when you refuse it, you become a corrupter of it.
So ba gba irere yala ko mo ja fun irere na to je irere otito tabi ko je to mu ki irere ko di baje.
Therefore,
nitori na,
the gospel of Christ,
irere Christi,
divides all men in the world into two opposing camps.
O pin gbogbo eniyan to ngbe lo ile aye yi si ipele meji.
Contenders,
awon to nja fun igbagbo.
Corrupters,
awon to nba igbagbo je.
And Paul did something with Timothy.
Paul ṣe nkan pẹlu Timothy.
He began,
o bẹrẹ,
but he did not finish that thing.
Ko pari ohun yen.
He began tracing the long line of contenders for the faith with Timothy, and he left you and me today to finish the rest of that line.
O bẹrẹ pẹlu ila to gun awon to nja fun igbagbo o so fun Timothy o wa duro nbe yen o fi iwo atemi sile lati pari ila na.
Then when he finished that,
igba to pari
yen, he started a long line of corruptors of the faith.
O wa pa ila to gun awon to mu ki ire ko di baje,
and he drew the line up to his own time, leaving you and me to complete the line up to our time.
O pa ila yen de gogo sa ati re o wa fi iwo atemi sile ka pari eyi to ku.
And then he did another thing with Timothy.
O ti se omiran pẹlu Timothy.
He said, Timothy,
only Timothy,
as for me, I have cast my lot, and this is where my lot is. I've cast my lot with the contenders for the faith.
Emi ti fi ipinu temi mo ti fi han baye ibi to wa na re o mo wa ni abala awon to nja fun igbagbo.
And then he urged that young man,
o wa ro odomokunrin yen,
as he does you and me today, urging us,
o se ro iwo atemi na loni,
that we should also cast our lot with the contenders for the faith.
Pe ka mu ipin wa yiyan ti wa ka fi sodo awon to nja fun igbagbo.
So that as we are here today,
ba se wa nbi loni,
you cannot be neutral to the gospel.
You are
either a contender for it or you are a corrupter of it. And he tells us the long line and the manifestations and characteristics of the contenders as well as the corruptors.
And
now in 2 Timothy chapter 3, as we look at these verses 8 to 13 together, we look at 3 points. One, opposition and persecution of faithful preachers.
Atako ati inu ibini ti awon alatako ati awon to nse inu ibini ti awon oniwaso otito.
The opposition and persecution of faithful preachers.
Idojuko ati ninu bini ta nse si awon onigbagbo to jolo oto.
Number 2,
ikeji,
openness and purity keys to forceful preaching.
Ìṣiṣẹ́ ara ẹni pa yá àti jíjẹ aláàpọn ó jẹ́ kọ́kọ́rọ́.
Purity.
Okay. Ṣiṣẹ́ ara ẹni pa yá àti ìwà funfun ó jẹ́ kọ́kọ́rọ́ náà sí ìwà àtúntò lọ́rìn.
Openness and purity as keys to forceful preaching.
À ń sọ fún wa ṣiṣẹ́ ara ẹni pa yá àti ìwà funfun gẹ́gẹ́ bí kọ́kọ́rọ́ náà fún ìwà àtúntò lọ́rìn.
Number 3,
ìkẹta,
the offense and punishment of fake preachers, false preachers.
Ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ àti ìjìyà àwọn alumọ oníwàásù.
The offense and the punishment of false preachers, fake preachers.
Ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ àti ìjìyà àwọn oníwàásù tó jẹ́ alumọ.
Now in 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 8,
Timothy kejì orí kẹsẹsẹ
kẹjọ, the opposition and persecution of faithful preachers.
À ń wo àtakò àti inú níbí ni àwọn oníwàásù tó jọ lóòótọ́.
Now as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth, men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith.
Ǹjẹ́ gẹ́gẹ́ bí Jannesi àti Jambres ti kọjú ìyà sí Mose, bẹ́ẹ̀ ni àwọn wọ̀nyí kọjú ìyà sí òtítọ́, àwọn ènìyàn tí inú wọn ti bàjẹ́, àwọn ẹni ìtanù àní ti ọ̀rọ̀ ìgbàgbọ́.
From time immemorial,
láti ọjọ́ tó ti gùn gan ná,
conflicts have always arisen.
Àti pé ìjà á pọn, ó máa ń ṣẹlẹ̀.
Between the preachers of truth and the polluters of truth.
Láàárín àwọn oníwàásù òtítọ́ àtàwọn tó ń bọ̀ òtítọ́ jẹ́.
Between those that stand for righteousness and those that oppose righteousness.
Láàárín àwọn tó dúró lórí òdodo àtàwọn
It started with Moses. In Genesis, it was in Exodus, it was a man God sent to go and confront the evil of his day. Oppression of man by man. God told Moses, said, go and tell them, Pharaoh, let my people go,
that
they may serve me. And Moses was a representative of God, and Pharaoh was a representative of the devil, as it was at that time. So it is today. Light and darkness are always in opposition, and the fight has been on for a long time. And you find Moses obeying God and going to Pharaoh. When he got there, and God gave him signs and wonders to work, he said, let my people go, to show you that it's God that sent me. And then he took the rod, and he threw the thing down, and he became a serpent. And Pharaoh would normally be afraid. He would normally be, he would say, maybe this man, maybe God has sent him. Look at stick in his hand, suddenly became serpent. And then here came this magician. Here came these people, servants of Satan. These opposers of the truth. These people who have lying wonders. And then they said, don't mind him. What is the big thing? What he has done? We also can do the same thing. And lo and behold, they took their stick, exactly the miracle that Moses performed. And that hardened the heart of Pharaoh.
He
said, so when you did miracle, my people can perform miracle also. Instead of falling on his knees and calling upon God, he put his arms akimbo like this. He said, what next? That tells you something. When you find preachers, when you find people preaching, and their preaching don't make people to fear God and to fear sin and to respect God, their preaching makes them to make their people listening to them bold and confident against God. Against righteousness. Against holiness. You know those are the relatives of Jannes and Jambres. They withstood Moses. They said, Moses, you cannot do that thing here. Anything you do, we can do it also. And the Bible tells us, Jannes and Jambres received Moses. But they are the first in the long line of opposers, corrupters of the gospel. Do you not understand it's not every miracle that comes from God? And they are still in the world today, corrupters of the gospel. Unfortunately, many people in the world are so gullible, they are easy to deceive. And some people in this our Bible church, we are also gullible, easy to deceive. They think they are deceiving us when they sneak here and there. They look here and there. They don't see anybody. They run to the house of somebody who says, they say he's performing miracle. And then they go to their night vigil. They go to their prayer mountain. They go to their so-called whatever miracle services. They go to their deliverance meetings. And they don't find out. They don't know the secret of the life, of the magic of these people. They say it's miracle, but it's actually magic. And they will not wait for God to answer their prayer. Give them what they need. Change their circumstance. They will run after this fake preachers. And some of them, after they have done it secretly for some time, when they come out to the open, they are no longer in deeper life. Where are you now? They will mention a place. And what is it they see in that place? Not the message of God. Not the message that sets your life straight. Not the word of God that establishes righteousness in your heart. Not the word of God that makes you to live a straight life. But the thing they go there for is, you know, the thing they call miracle. And Jannes and Jambres have to be their disciples today.
Hey,
you find that Zerubbabel was also working for God. And as he was serving the Lord, you find these people resisting him. The princes and the priests of Judah, they resisted that man. The enemy land who were occupying Israel. By the time Israel came back from captivity in Babylon, they opposed that man Zerubbabel. And then they said, no, you cannot do this. Look at Ezra chapter 4. They stood against him. In Ezra chapter 4, let's look at it now from verse the third verse. Ezra chapter 4, verse 3. But Zerubbabel and Joshua and the rest of the chief of the fathers of Israel said unto them, you have nothing to do with us to build an house unto our God, but we ourselves together will build unto the Lord God of Israel, as King Cyrus the king of Persia has commanded us.
Ṣùgbọ́n Zerubbabel àti Joshua àti ìyókù nínú àwọn olórí àwọn baba Israeli wí fún wọn pé kìí ṣe fún àwa pẹ̀lú ẹ̀yin láti jùmọ̀ kọ ilé fún Ọlọ́run wa, ṣùgbọ́n àwa tìkára wa ni yóò jùmọ̀ kọ ilé fún Olúwa Ọlọ́run Israeli.
Then the people of the land, they weakened the hands of the people of Judah and troubled them in building. These people wanted to do what God sent them to do. To build the wall. My brothers and sisters, how is it now that many of us, you want to build and you don't want opposition? These people wanted to be ordinary world. But that world was commanded by God. Not even to save souls, not just to build world. They said no. They cannot build it. They weakened their hands. They weakened their hands.
And
it's still happening today. Then in verse 5, they hired counselors against them to frustrate their purpose. All the days of Cyrus king of Persia, even until the reign of Darius king of Persia. That's the opposition. That's the persecution we're talking about. You have a purpose. I want to build
strength.
I want to build a church that will be straight on the word of God. That the plumb line, like the word the carpenters and bricklayers, the plumb line, it plumbs straight with the word of God. It will not be this way and zigzag like that. How do you want to do that kind of thing and you are not looking for opposition? You know the story of Sambalat and Tobiah. Long line of opposers of the gospel. They stood against that man. No, they said you cannot do it. We will not allow you. They resisted him. It was a tough battle. And it lasted for a long time. Those are resisters of the truth. I don't know whether you know this story about Jeremiah. In Jeremiah chapter 26, he also was a contender for the faith. And when he was doing the war, I studied the life of that man. When he started his prophecy, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, no problem. I followed from chapter to chapter to chapter. He preached and he said everything. Oh, there was no difficulty.
Oh, well, so sorry, she didn't go to Allah.
Until he got to about chapter 20.
Ìgbà tó wá ń dé bí orí ogun.
And then these people began to wake up.
Àwọn wọ̀nyí bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí tají lójú oorun wọn.
Wait o.
Dúró ń bẹ̀ yẹn.
This man that is preaching all the time like this.
Ọkùnrin tó ń sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ ń gbà gbogbo yìí.
We have to deal with him.
Ẹja bàjá.
And so that's how the problem with Jeremiah started.
Bí wàhálà Jeremiah ṣe bẹ̀rẹ̀ nìyẹn.
After every message.
Lẹ́yìn gbogbo ìwàásù.
That somebody will stand up.
Ẹnìkan á dìde.
And we oppose that man.
Yóò dako.
Until we get to this one interesting story. Chapter 26. And in verse 8, now it came to pass, when Jeremiah had made an end of speaking all that the Lord had commanded him to speak unto all the people, that the prince, can you imagine, prince, and the prophets, and all the people, they took him, saying, thou shalt surely die.
O si se, nigba ti Jeremiah pari gbogbo oro ti Oluwa pase fun lati so fun gbogbo eniyan, nigba na ni awon alufa se ko wa ya ni lenu. Àwọn àlùfáà àti àwọn wòlíì àti gbogbo èèyàn dì í mú pé kíkú ni ìwọ ó kú.
Why has thou prophesied in the name of the Lord, saying, this house shall be like Shiloh, and this city shall be desolate without an inhabitant? And all the people were gathered against Jeremiah in the house of the Lord. When the princes of Judah heard these things, then they came up from the king's house unto the house of the Lord, and they sat down in the entry of the new gate of the Lord's house. Then spoke the priests and the prophets unto the princes and to all the people, saying, this man is worthy to die, for he has prophesied against this city, as you have heard with your ears. You think Jeremiah will begin to apologize and say, I'm sorry? No. He said, then spake Jeremiah unto all the princes and to all the people, saying, the Lord sent me to prophesy against this house and against this city all the words that you have heard. Therefore now, you continue the preaching again. Contender. Amend your way and your doing, and obey the voice of the Lord your God, and the Lord will repent him of evil that he has denounced or pronounced against you. As for me, behold, I am in your hand. Do with me as seemeth good and meet unto you. But know ye for certain that if you put me to death, you shall surely bring innocent blood upon yourselves. Let me stop there.
That's the question. Èyí ṣe tí ìwọ́n sì sọ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ ní orúkọ Olúwa wípé ilé yìí yóò dàbí Ṣílò àti ìlú yóò di ahoro láìní olùgbé. Gbogbo ènìyàn kójọpọ̀ sí Jeremiah ní ilé Olúwa. Nígbà náà ni àwọn ìjòyè Júdà gbọ́ nǹkan wọ̀nyí. Wọ́n jáde láti ilé ọba wá sí ilé Olúwa. Wọ́n sì jókòó ní ẹnà títún ilé Olúwa. Àwọn àlùfáà àti àwọn wòlíì wí fún àwọn ìjòyè àti gbogbo ènìyàn pé ọkùnrin yìí jẹ̀bi ikú nítorí tí ó sọ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ sí ìlú yìí. Bí ẹ̀yin ti fi etí yín gbọ́, o rò pé Jeremiah yóò máa bẹ̀bẹ̀ yóò máa wárìrì bẹ́ẹ̀ kọ́. Nígbà náà ni Jeremiah wí fún àwọn ìjòyè àti gbogbo ènìyàn pé Olúwa rán mi láti sọ àsọtẹ́lẹ̀ gbogbo ọ̀rọ̀ tí ẹ̀yin gbọ́. Sí ilé yìí àti sí ìlú yìí, ó tún bẹ̀rẹ̀ ìwàásù ẹ̀ ní ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá. Ǹjẹ́ nísinsìnyí ẹ tú ọ̀nà yín àti iṣẹ́ yín ṣe, kí ẹ sì gbọ́ ohun Olúwa Ọlọ́run yín. Olúwa yóò sì yí ọkàn rẹ̀ padà ní ti ibi tí ó sọ sí yín. Bí ó ṣe ti èmi ṣáàwó, èmi ń bẹ ní ọwọ́ yín. Ẹ ṣe tí mi gẹ́gẹ́ bí ó ti dára, tí ó sì yẹ lójú yín. Síbẹ̀ ẹ mọ èyí dájú pé bí ẹ bá pa mí, mi mú ni ẹ̀yin ò mú ẹ̀jẹ̀ aláìṣẹ̀ wá sórí yín. Kò dá dúró ń bẹ̀.
That man was a contender.
Ọkùnrin yìí jẹ́ tó ń jà síta
síta. When I read people like this, Old Testament people.
Bí n bá ka àwọn èèyàn nínú májẹ̀mú láyé bí eléyìí.
I say, God, you need to help me more.
Màá wá bi Ọlọ́run pé Ọlọ́run dákun rẹ̀ mí náà lọ́wọ́
síwájú. You finish a message.
Ó parí wàásù.
And you spoke as God put in your mouth.
Ó sọ̀rọ̀ bọ́lá ṣe fi tẹ́ ọ lẹ́nu.
It may be on a crusade field.
Ó lè jẹ́ lórí àyè ìta gbangba tá a
ti wà. May even be inside a church building.
Ó lè jẹ́ nínú ilé ìjọsìn.
And you say all that God wants you to say.
Ohun gbogbo Ọlọ́run náà ló sọ.
And then there are some people somewhere.
Àwọn kan níbì kan kó ra pẹ́ ọkọ̀.
Then they show you, they let you know, we don't like that.
Wọ́n gbórí gbóyà, wọ́n wá ń bá ọ wípé ohun tó wàásù yẹn àwa ò fẹ́.
And then you begin to feel, how do I do it now?
Ìwọ náà wọ́n bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ònà oníwàásù ni ó tọ́lọ́ ojẹ́ṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run pé bóun ni kí n wá ṣe báyìí.
Then you begin to preach message to counter that, to balance everything.
Ìwàásù bẹ̀rẹ̀ ìwàásù mìíràn tọ́lọ́run òun rẹ̀ láti ṣe àtúntò fún àwọn ènìyàn náà.
Jeremiah sẹ́.
Jeremiah wí pé.
All that I told you, God told you, ask me to tell you.
Ohun gbogbo tí mo sọ fún yín, iṣẹ́ tọ́lọ́run rán mi ni mo jẹ́.
He said, let me, I've not finished the preaching.
Mo ní mi ti parí wàásù.
And he started the preaching all over again.
Ó tún bẹ̀rẹ̀ wàásù lẹ́ẹ̀kan
sí. He said, you amend your way.
Ẹ tún ọ̀nà yín ṣe.
They had sword in their hands. Can you preach? see there's gun in the hand of someone against you.
Àwọn alátakò Jeremiah ní ìdà lọ́wọ́ wọn. Ṣé wọ́n lè wà ọ́sùn tán bá gbé ìbọn dò tí wọ́n gbé ìbọn dò tí wọ́n ti ọ̀ bá.
They were talking of death. Jeremiah was still preaching.
Wọ́n sọ̀rọ̀ ikú. Jeremiah ń wà sùn.
You, it's not death you are talking about here.
Àwa tá a wà ń bí ìwọ tó wà ń bí a ti sọ̀rọ̀ ikú náà.
They're only talking about you, these deeper people. You, these holy people. You, these people who are not social. You, these people. Don't you see how we are changing?
Àwa tá a wà ń bí wọn àti gbébọn ti wá báyìí pé ohun tọ́kàn sọ náà ni pé ẹ̀yin mímọ́ mímọ́ mọ̀ yé ẹ̀yin ará àdìbà wọ̀n yé mímọ́ jáni ti yín ẹ̀wà àdìbà yìí pẹ̀lú nǹkan tó ń sọ yẹn àti ń yí padà.
Hey, you people, you deeper, you are outdated. You are not flowing with the society. You are not moving with civilization. You all this you see, even those of you who are so educated, see the way you all doing like as if you are not in this world. And that's all they say. They are not even killing you. They're not even throwing any stone at you. They're not even trying to, you know, do you any evil. It's just that they are looking at you and they make their mouth in a kind of way. And this, you are changing. And then you begin to see, hey, actually, hey, we are also changing. We are also good. We are also trying. And you try to defend God. And defend God without the word of God. And then the next time you are going to go to tailor, they will tell the tailor, please let me sew it like this. Not totally like before, but please. And then you make amends. You change your all those styles. And then you are trying to be like them so they won't talk against you. Listen to me. When you try to please the world, when you think you have done your best, they are going to ask you for more. You can never satisfy the world.
Àwa ní ohun tó kàn sọ náà ni pé ẹ̀bá ara ayé mu mọ̀mọ́ ṣe ń ṣe láwùjọ gbogbo ẹ̀yin tẹ́ ẹ kàwé lára yín náà ẹ̀wò bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe ń wọ̀ ẹ̀wò bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe ń wọṣọ. Wọ́n ti sọ òkúta kan sọ́dù wá. Wọ́n ti gbé ìbọn tàbí ọ̀kọ̀ọ̀kan mu wá kan fẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ wa lórí. Wọ́n ti ṣe gbogbo ìyẹn. Àwa náà abẹ̀ ti jẹ́ díẹ̀ díẹ̀. Abẹ̀ ti yí àwa lọ bá tẹ́lọ̀ báyìí. Abẹ̀ ti fi yí aṣọ bá ṣe ránṣọ. À ń yí padà. A fẹ́ ti aráyé lọ́rùn. Jẹ́ kí n sọ fún ọ. Nígbà tó bá lọ ọ̀sẹ̀ tí ipa ti ayé láti ti aráyé lọ́rùn. Nígbà tó rò ti ṣe pa àti rẹ tán. Wọ́n bèèrè lọ́wọ́ rẹ láti ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀ sí. A wà máa gbìyànjú láti ṣàlàyé ara wa. À ń gbèjà Ọlọ́run láì lo ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
If you come into the New Testament,
Sọba ti máa jẹ̀mú.
Elymas, you know the sorcerer, he resisted Paul.
Elima Oṣó, o tako Paul.
He opposed Paul.
O tako Paul.
Although Paul was a great apostle.
Paul yà fún tóli ńlá.
Yet he was resisted.
Síbẹ̀ atako náà.
He was opposed.
Adojúkọ.
And you know the outcome of that.
Ẹ mọ àbáyọrí yẹn.
In 2 Timothy chapter 4.
Timothy kejì orí kẹrin.
2 Timothy chapter 4.
Timothy kejì orí kẹrin.
And verse 14.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹrìnlá.
2 Timothy 4:14.
Timothy kejì orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ kẹrìnlá.
Alexander the coppersmith did me much evil.
Alexander alágbẹ̀dẹ bàbá ṣe mí ní ibi púpọ̀.
The Lord reward him according to his works.
Olúwa yóò san fún gẹ́gẹ́ bí iṣẹ́ rẹ̀.
Oh, that's painful.
Ìyẹn gan roni lára.
Paul said, you see that Alexander.
Ṣé Alexander rù?
The evil he did against me.
Ibi tó ṣe sí mi.
Anyway, God will pay him back.
Ọlọ́run á san fún.
And in verse 15, he said, of whom be thou ware, beware also, for he has greatly withstood our words.
Lọ́dọ̀ ẹni tí kì í wọ kí ó máa ṣọ́ra pẹ̀lú ó nítorí tí ó kọjú ìjà sí ìwàásù wa púpọ̀.
He withstood our words.
Ó kọjú ìjà sí ìwàásù wa.
Timothy.
Oní Timothy.
You better don't be jellyfish.
Mama jẹ́ ẹja tó légun ẹyin.
God has not given us the spirit of fear and trembling.
Olúwa fún alẹ́mí ẹ̀rù àti ìwárìrì.
He has given you all the spirit of a sound mind.
Ó fún alẹ́mí tó yẹ kóró.
You have to prepare.
Gbáradì.
If you are going to take men to heaven.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ bá fẹ́ mú èèyàn lọ sọ́run.
Get ready for problems.
Ẹ ṣe tán láti dojúkọ ìṣòro.
If you are going to lead people to salvation.
Ó padà dáwọ̀ ẹ̀ sí ìgbàlà.
Get ready for opposition.
Múra sílẹ̀ pé a dojúkọ.
Satan will oppose you.
Èṣù àtakò ọ́.
The world will oppose you.
Ayé àtakò ọ́.
Some of the people you are trying to help will oppose you.
Lára àwọn tó ń gbìyànjú láti ràn lọ́wọ́ máa tako ìwọ náà.
If you don't have backbone.
Bó o bá lẹ́gun ẹ̀yìn.
You will not be able to stand.
O ní le dúró ti báyìí.
Timothy.
Timothy.
Ọjọ́ àmàna pọ́sù yìí ló mú.
Àpótọ́lì ni mí ò mọ̀ mí.
Alexander the coppersmith.
Alexander alágbẹ̀dẹ bàbá.
He did me much evil.
Ó ṣe mí ní ibi púpọ̀.
The Lord will pay him back.
Olúwa yóò san fún.
In 1 Timothy chapter 1, this Alexander, who was he?
Ní Timothy kìíní, Alexander rí tani gan.
Well, don't know, but there was another Alexander in chapter 1.
A ò mọ̀, ṣùgbọ́n ní orí kìíní Alexander kan tún wà ń bẹ̀.
1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 19.
Timothy kìíní orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ kọkàn.
Holding faith and a good conscience, which some having put away concerning faith have made shipwreck, of whom is Hymenaeus and Alexander, whom I have delivered unto Satan, that they may learn not to blaspheme.
Máa ní ìgbàgbọ́ àti èrè ọkàn rere. Èyí tí àwọn ẹlòmíràn sànù kúrò lọ́dọ̀ wọn tí wọ́n sì rí ọkọ̀ ìgbàgbọ́ wọn nínú àwọn ẹni tí Hymenaeus àti Alexander wà, àwọn tí mo ti fi lé Sátani lọ́wọ́.
Why did this Alexander wound Paul so much? Because he knew the preaching. He had learned the teaching. Somehow, somewhere, he had had contact with the apostles. Somehow, somewhere, he had been taught the Bible. Somehow, somewhere, he had sat under the preaching, the ministry of those men of God. Then he made shipwreck. I pray for you, you will not make shipwreck. It's terrible for a man to make shipwreck. It's better not to start the journey at all. But he made shipwreck. And then he will be telling the people. He said, look here, I have gone through it before. I have tried it before. And I want to assure you, it's all lies. And by so saying, they make many people to make shipwreck. Also, they destroy the faith of many. And Paul said, this thing they have done is so bad, I deliver them to Satan. Just telling you, part of your position may be people that have been part of us before. Why should it trouble me? If somebody who has been in the forefront of the battle, somebody who has been as like an aide, somebody like a lieutenant, and then all of a sudden changes and begins to oppose and blaspheme,
did
it trouble me? Has it not happened before?
How
was Alexander not part of the number before? But Alexander or no Alexander, we're going to contend for the faith. And so you find those people, they were resisted. And as you come to contemporary time, you find people who are resisted or poor. You have heard of Martin Luther before? Oh, that man was opposed. He faced difficulty. I cannot begin to tell you now the difficulty that man faced. But there was opposition. But that man said, no, I'm going to contend for this thing. You have heard of John Bunyan, the man who wrote Pilgrim's Progress. There was opposition, real persecution. In fact, at the time, they put him in prison. I think he was in prison for, I think, about 11 years or so. And then, you know, just for preaching, they said he was preaching. Preaching without license. From the government. And so, they put him in prison. And after staying in the prison for a long time, that man, he knew the structure of the prison. And he knew the kind of place where people could stand. I don't know how he arranged it. But you know what will happen? Every Sunday, he will stand in his prison, facing the thick wall. Many people will stand outside at the open opposite the prison outside there. He will be preaching to them.
He
cannot see them, just walk. But he will be shouting, I'm preaching. And the people who stand outside the prison, they will be listening to the message.
People
who contended for the faith. Recently I was preaching about the founder of the Salvation Army Church, William Booth and his wife. And I saw how they contended for the faith. You know, whenever they were going to preach like that, they were ready. Because it is normal practice. They will be pelted with stones, pelted with rotten apples, pelted with rotten tomato, pelted with rotten eggs. It's normal life. Yes, that man, in the dirtiest part of London. When I say dirty, not dirty road, I'm talking about dirty life, the most terrible place in London, he raised the Salvation Army that reached the whole world.
Yes.
Nothing in my hands I bring, simply to the cross I cling. Rock of ages left for me, let me hide myself in thee. And he always preach on salvation on Sundays. And he will tell people, don't need to pay anything. Then he quotes that song. You know what that man did? He went to the newspaper. He said, Mr. Preacher, we are sufficiently informed about the emptiness of your hand. Tell us another thing. You said nothing, my hand that brings. That's how you said it. That's how you said it. That. We know your hand is empty. Tell us another thing. That's our opposition every time. Kept on preaching all the same. I'm learning lesson now. When I preach and you frown, I just close my eyes and keep on preaching. When I preach and you do your body to let me know I don't like it, I just close my eyes and keep on preaching. When I preach and you send those signals to me that this thing you are saying I don't like, I keep on preaching because I want to join the long line of contenders. Today, our church is resisted and opposed by preachers of eternal security. People who preach, you can divorce and get married to another woman. Those who say there is no restitution in the Bible. Those who say there is nothing like sanctification as a second definite work of grace. So teach us to identify with the world rather than separate from the world. They oppose us today. Why not? They have to. Whoever stood for pure religion without facing opposition, they accuse us that we are too serious with the Bible. They say we are too strict in lifestyle. You know what somebody says? He said, deeper life. He was telling someone, you can't join them. You can't go to them. Their own faith. He said, it's like the faith of Paul, Apostle Paul. He said, you know, Apostle Paul's faith was even more than that of Jesus Christ. That these deeper life people, they are like Apostle Paul. No, you can't join them if you are not serious. That's what they are saying. You know, they accuse us. We are too strict, too disciplined, too heaven conscious, too rigid with our convictions. I want to ask you, can we be otherwise? Are we not persuaded of what we have been taught? And the Bible says, 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 12, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. And now some of us have been intimidated. We are being stung by all those criticisms they are giving to us. We are becoming too self-conscious of ourselves because of what they are saying. See our messages. See our dressing. See our association. See, deeper life person will be attending what they call Iwuye. Somebody is doing Iwuye in another church. You say, Iwuye in the church of God. Chief says this title. And you say, something. Then you leave Sunday worship. You leave Jesus only as our message. Jesus all our theme shall be. We will lift up Jesus ever. Jesus only we will preach. Jesus only, Jesus ever. Jesus all in all we sing. Savior, sanctifier, healer, baptizer, and coming king. You leave that. You go to where they are doing Iwuye. Then you get there and say, okay, the family of the person doing Iwuye will now come forward now to come and give the offering. Then you all dance to the front. Deep alive. Somebody is getting to wanting to get married. Look at the belly of the wife like this. Deeper life. You see, it's my brother. I have to go. And you, and they will get. They will not only go. They will even be the champions of everything. All the birthday parties they do in the world, we go with them now, don't we? Somebody has died 10 years ago. They want to do another one. Don't we attend now? These things, we say they are small, small things, but that is the evidence of the rottenness that is inside. That you will go to herbalist. Because there is problem.
Hey,
you say I'm deep, but help me. Oh, let Jesus come quickly. Because things are bad. Things are terrible. Because there are no people to contend anymore. And we do all this to appease the world. Can't we be like Paul? Remain separated from the world. And be pricking the conscience of the world with our lifestyle. Why don't we be like Paul and be different from them? You know what? Even in the church, sometimes we even face opposition. And we who are members of the church, we should beware of opposing our pastors, our preachers. What we need from you is cooperation. What we need from you is, you know, support. What we need is love. We need your love. And we need your constructive criticism. Who don't oppose our preachers? Hosea chapter 4 verse 4. You will see that man Hosea was a prophet as well, and he made an observation in his own day. The Lord spoke to him to speak to the people of Israel. Let no man strive nor reprove another, for thy people are as they that strive with the priests. They strive with the priest. In Isaiah chapter 30, and in verse 8, here it says, remove far from me vanity and lies. Isaiah chapter 30 verse 8. For now go, write it before them in a table. Note it in a book, that it may be for the time to come, forever and ever, that this is a rebellious people, lying children. Children that will not hear the law of the Lord, which say to the seers, see not. And to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things. Speak unto us smooth things. Prophesy deceit.
Isaiah 30:8 láti ẹsẹ̀ kẹjọ nísinsìnyí lọ kọ́ níwájú wọn tí wà láàkan sì kọ́ sínú ìwé kan kí ó lè jẹ́ fún ìgbà tí ń bọ̀ láé àti láéláé pé ọlọ́tẹ̀ ènìyàn ni àwọn wọ̀nyí àwọn ọmọ èké àwọn ọmọ tí kò fẹ́ gbọ́ òfin Olúwa tí wọ́n ń wí fún aríran pé má ṣe ríran àti fáwọn wòlíì pé má sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ ohun tí ó tọ́ fún wa sọ nǹkan dídùn fún wa.
These were prophets, these were Israelites. People that the God sent those prophets to. They told their prophets, say, don't tell us that kind of message. Say smooth things. Smooth things. Why is it all the time? This hard thing.
Isn't
there any other thing anymore?
In
Jeremiah chapter 11.
Jeremiah,
and verse 21. And it says, therefore thus says the Lord of the men of Anano that seek thy life, saying, prophesy not in the name of the Lord, that thou die not by our hand. You see there, hey, what did they tell those people? Don't speak. Don't talk. And we should not be like that. You know, I hear people, he says, you know, I don't profit under the message anymore. The message doesn't even touch me anymore. And the thing that is the source, where the message is coming from, that has problem. They are the people that have problem. Somebody goes into a heinous sin. Terrible sin. And all the time he's committing that sin. He's hearing the word of God. Hearing the word of God on
cassettes.
Hearing the one everywhere. Hearing the one in the live message. And says, you know, it's because the messages I was hearing were not doing me any good. That's why I went into all those evil. That's hypocrisy. If you want to hear the word of God, God spoke to Balaam through an ass. We are better than asses by the grace of God. How is it that a man could hear from an ass and you cannot hear from a human being? And you make that an excuse for going to a sin that heaven must not even hear about. And then we say it's because, you know, the message was not doing me anything anymore. Because I don't like this person. I don't like the way he talks. I don't like the corrections he made in my life. You want to blackmail the preacher? So that preacher will not be able to make correction again. So that the preacher will be afraid. And will not be able to tell you what is wrong in your life. If we cannot speak the truth anymore, it's better to die.
While
be alive and you are seeing truth and you cannot. You people want a pastor who will see something wrong and will not tell you, who will see you do evil and will not speak, who will see you deviate by an inch and you will be afraid to talk because it's just an inch, and wait until you are completely lost. I made a covenant. Before I came here, I made a covenant with the Lord. Long before I came to Dipala, I made a covenant with the Lord. No man on earth is going to make me change that covenant. Oh yes, there may be little problem here, mistakes here, and there. That's okay. When we make mistakes, we pray and we make corrections, and then we go on. But if you sit there and you are committing sin, you are doing evil, and you are hearing the word of God, instead of telling yourself that it is because you have hardened your heart, you don't want to go to heaven anymore, then you say, I was hearing the word of God all that time, but because the person preaching, I don't like him, that's why I didn't get blessed, and that's why I was going to sin every time. Pray. Your blood will be on your head. The Bible tells us that evil men and seducers will work worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. In 1 Corinthians chapter 16, and in verse 10, 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 10, this was Paul writing to the Corinthians. Look up at me here. You know Corinthians? You know the problem Paul had with them? Even Paul, that was a bold man. But Paul that feared nobody. Paul that can look at a governor in the face and talk to him. He had a problem with the Corinthians. How much more now Timothy, young man, timid young man. And so, look at the passage now. Now, if Timotheus come, see that he may be with you without fear. For he walketh the work of the Lord, as I also do. Let no man therefore despise him, but conduct him forth in peace, that he may come unto me, for I look for him with the brethren.
Ǹjẹ́ bí Timothy bá dé, ẹjọ́ kí ó wà lọ́dọ̀ yín láì bẹ̀rù, nítorí òun ṣe iṣẹ́ Olúwa bí èmi ti pẹ̀lú ti ń ṣe. Nítorí náà, kí ẹnikẹ́ni kí ó má ṣe kẹ́gàn rẹ̀, ṣùgbọ́n ẹ̀sìn jáde lọ́nà àjò ní àlàáfíà.
You see Timothy, if he got to the Corinthian church, and he stands like this, and he sees those people sitting down, and he has had the problem they gave Paul the apostle, and then he wants to preach, and then he will be looking down like this. He will not be able to look up. Because the faces of those people. And Paul told those Corinthians. So if Timothy comes to you, make sure you don't do anything that will make him afraid of you. It's not to your profit. If your preacher fears you, and he cannot tell you the word of God, he cannot speak to you and tell you, thus says the Lord, it's not to your advantage. And so if Timothy has come to you, see that he's not afraid. But when he comes, let no man despise him. Because you know, those Corinthians could just look like this without even saying anything. And the way they even look, you wanted to say without holiness before you swallow it. May you not be like that. Now, that's opposition. And you know, the Bible, Paul told us about those people, opposers, and you know, people persecuting. Number one, he said they were men of corrupt minds. Number two, he said they were reprobate concerning the faith. They were already lost base metal, useless metal. That's the meaning of reprobate. Base metal, useless metal. That you cannot use for anything. Number three, he said they were foolish about eternal things. He said their foolishness will soon be made known to everybody. Number four, they were evil men and seducers. They were seducing others into false doctrine. Number five, they were deceived and deceiving others out of the way of truth. Against the backdrop of these kinds of people, Paul now gives us another thing. And he brings us, he says, forget about the opposers. Look at the contenders. My brothers and sisters, please be patient with the message. Be patient because of time. And Paul said, he said, look away from all those opposers. That's what I want to tell you. Look away from all the opposers. Deeper life is like, deeper life is like, forget about them. Look at the contenders for the faith. Take us to point number two. Openness and purity as keys to forceful preaching. In verse 10, now 2 Timothy chapter 3, Paul said, Timothy, I told you about the opposers, the Jannes and the Jambres. He said, but Timothy, you have fully known my life, my doctrine, manner of life, my purpose, my faith, my long suffering. You know my charity, you know my patience, you know the persecutions I suffered, you know the afflictions I had, you know the persecutions I had, you know how God delivered me. Paul told Timothy, he said, you know Timothy, look at my life. I am a shining example of a faithful Christian and a faithful minister. Timothy, don't you know it? You know my life in secret and in public. You know my doctrine. You know my purpose in life. You know my faith. You know everything about me.
Timothy,
you know, I don't live covered up life. It's open. Timothy, don't you know it? You know everything. He said, you are fully known all about my life. That Paul was telling us that his life and his preaching had the force of a transparently holy life. And it's the same thing today. If you have no transparency in your life, if you have no purity in your life, you cannot preach the forceful message, the kind of message this world needs today. Sin will close your mouth. You may preach an academic message, but you will not preach a message that will transform life. Paul told Timothy. He said, you know, in me, holiness is power. He said, you know my life? You know my purpose? You know my relationship with women? You know my relationship with money? You know everything about me? I've not covered anything from you? And I don't have any secret anywhere? He said, Timothy, that's why I'm telling you that I am one of the contenders of the faith. And that's what will help you. If you are going to be able to preach forceful message that will get people on their knees. You can't say that if there is a girl in the choir there who is your girlfriend. You can't say that if there is a man over there who knows the lie you have spoken. You can't say that if there is somebody in the church who knows that the way you have been falsifying accounts. Paul said, you know everything. And all you are preachers here. If I check your message, and I see that you cannot lay it on the line again, I could be rambling here and there, That tells me something. Something is happening somewhere. Not message you preach when I'm sitting down. The one you preach when I'm not there. In your district church. In the local government, in the village, the messages you preach when we are not there. You know, when we are there, you can say something bold and everything fine. When you want to, if you are not living right and you want to preach, and as you want to talk, your two eyes and the eyes of those two girls, the two eyes of that girl meet together. You say, looks at you like that. You swallow it quickly.
The one you have been committing
sin with. And she's there in the church.
And we'll sit
like this.
So
we are here. This is our deeper life. We are here. All these, they are preachers. And you want to say, without holiness, it looks like you like this. So you can preach holiness. Where was holiness last night? You want to talk holiness now? The other time, where was holiness that time? That time, you said, please forget about holiness now. You know, forget it. That's
fine.
You get to the pulpit. When the church becomes like that, do we have church anymore? All you single sisters here, I can talk to the face of any of you. And all of you married women here, I can talk to the face of every. You are all here. Stand up if there is anything. Talk. Go and say, if you can't say it because I'm here, take your pen, write to the Lagos, and tell them there is somebody there who is deceiving you. The man handling this church money is here. I think he's sitting somewhere there. Stand up, let them see you. Look at him. Go and ask him if I'm not there. Ask him about your money. Sit down.
ẹni tó ń bójú tó owó ní rígíọ́nì yìí àwọn ọ̀la tó dìde yẹn wọ́n ní ká lọ bèrè lọ́wọ́ wọn tí olùṣàgùtàn bá ní májò agbọ́ kan nípa ìlú.
And all these there is one of them there, she works in the office with us. That, stand up, let them see you.
Arábìnrin yẹn náà ṣe ní ilé ní ẹsẹ̀
fún ìlàsẹ̀
wa ẹ lọ bí léèrè.
The one that took over, that she took over from, she was also a woman. Go and ask him. The wife, the husband is inside that room.
Ask him.
If she's here, if she's here, go and ask her. You know her. If you hear that you know people who are deceiving themselves and they're saying they are going to heaven and they are messing up, count me out by the grace of God. Openness. Purity as a key to forceful preaching. In Acts chapter 20, and in verse 20, and it says, how I kept back nothing that was profitable unto you, but I've showed you publicly, and I've taught you from house to house.
Only then you could be back then, that is on phone, so sharp, and if only, as you like my point in Bangba, as you like the lady,
26. Wherefore I take you to record this day that I'm pure from the blood of all men.
Nitorina Moko, in Shelley, Loni, Yipe, Arno, Mimoko, Nigeria, Gogo.
33, I have coveted no man's silver or gold or apparel.
Ese Keta, Lilogon. Emi ko se oju kokoro fadaka tabi wura tabi aso enikeni.
That's Paul talking.
Paul lo so
ro yen. He was sure about himself.
O so ni o dara e loju.
Are you sure about yourself?
Share o dara re loju.
Not in your strength, but by the grace of God.
It's the grace
of God, my brothers and sisters.
And
that grace is available. If you believe that, say amen.
Grace
to live a holy life is available. It's possible. And I believe it. In 2 Corinthians chapter
4
and verses 1 and 2. Therefore, since we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. But we have received the hidden things, we have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God.
Àwa kò rìn ní ẹ̀tàn bẹ́ẹ̀ ni àwa kò fi ọwọ́ ẹ̀tàn mú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ṣùgbọ́n nípa fífi òtítọ́ hàn àwa ń fi ara wa lẹ́ẹ̀rí ọkọ̀ oríkúlùkù ènìyàn lọ́wọ́ níwájú Ọlọ́run.
That's Paul giving his own testimony.
Ẹ̀rí Paul nìyẹn ó ń sọ fún ara rẹ̀.
In chapter 6,
orí kẹfà,
verse 1,
ẹsẹ̀ kìíní,
we then as workers together with him beseech you also that you receive not the grace of God in vain.
Ǹjẹ́ ibi alábàáṣiṣẹ́pọ̀ pẹ̀lú rẹ̀ wá ń bẹ̀ yín kí ẹ má ṣe gbọ́ orí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run lásán.
Verse 3, giving no offense in anything that the ministry be not blamed.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹta, a kò sì ṣe ohun ìkọ̀sẹ̀ ní ohunkóhun kí iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ kí ó má ṣe di ìsọ̀rọ̀
búburú sí. But in all things are proving ourselves as the ministers of God.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní ohun gbogbo àwa ń fi ara wa hàn bí àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run nínú ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ sùúrù.
We list all those things down.
Ó sọ àwọn àmúyẹ wọ̀nyẹn.
You can only serve the meal of forceful preaching, the kind of preaching the world needs today. We can only serve that meal in the plate of a transparently holy life.
Oúnjẹ tí aráyé nílò nípa ìwàásù òkodoro lónìí, a lè fún ọ ní irú oúnjẹ bẹ́ẹ̀ nínú àwo tó jẹ́ tó mọ́ gara tí ò ní àbàwọ́n nú.
And we preachers in deeper life.
Àwo oníwàásù níjọ deeper life.
Paul says,
Paul wípé,
Timothy, you know my doctrine.
Timothy, ohun ẹ̀kọ́ mi.
Are you teaching all the doctrines, everything?
Ìbéèrè náà rè sí wa, ṣé gbogbo ẹ̀kọ́ ìlà ń kọ́ ni?
That's what you are called to do.
Ohun tá a pè wá sí láti ṣe.
By life, by preaching, by example, lead people to heaven.
Nípa ìgbésí ayé rẹ, nípa àpẹẹrẹ rẹ, nípa ìwàásù rẹ, darí àwọn èèyàn lọ sí ìjọba
Ọlọ́run. Let's round off now as we go to the last point.
A fẹ́ ṣe àṣekágbá ní kókó kẹta
báyìí. The offense and punishment of false preachers.
Ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ àti ìjìyà àwọn oníwàásù èké.
2 Timothy chapter 3.
Timothy kejì orí kẹta.
And in verse 13.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá.
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 13.
Timothy kejì orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá.
And it says, talking to Timothy, it says, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
Paul ń sọ bá Timothy sọ̀rọ̀ ní ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá wípé ṣùgbọ́n àwọn èèyàn búburú àti àwọn ẹlẹ́tàn yóò máa gbilẹ̀ síwájú sí, wọn ó máa tán ni jẹ, a ó sì máa tàn wọ́n jẹ.
Evil men Seducers, deceivers, that's their offense. They deceive other people into falsehood. They seduce other people into sin. They do evil that good may abound. That's their offense. They offer false hope to people seeking the way to heaven.
But
the Bible says they shall wax worse and worse. As they try to come out, they go deeper into sin. Because they have not repented genuinely and turned away from it. So the more they try, the more they land into sin. And so you find that both the deceiver and the deceived will come under judgment. He says the deceivers, they shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. Both of them will face judgment. Both the serpent and Eve came under judgment. If you allow anyone to deceive you, all you young DLS over there, if you allow anyone to deceive you, both the deceiver and you, the deceived, you come under judgment. And all those of you are, you know, living your life in various other places, if you allow somebody to deceive you, it's not living right. And it's telling you that it's not possible to live right. And you also, you are deceived. Both the deceiver and the deceived will come under judgment. In Matthew chapter 7. And in verse 21. And it says, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have we not cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works? And then I will profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that walk in iniquity. Get away from here. Okay. May you not hear their voice in Jesus' name.
Ọpọlọpọ ènìyàn yóò gún mi ní ọjọ́ náà pé Olúwa Olúwa àwa kò á sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ ní orúkọ rẹ àti orúkọ rẹ kí a fi dé àwọn ẹ̀mí ẹ̀ṣù jáde àti ní orúkọ rẹ kí a fi ṣe ọ̀pọ̀ iṣẹ́ ìyanu ńlá nígbà náà ni ó wọ́n sì jẹ́wọ́ wí fún wọn pé èmi kò mọ̀ yín ẹ lọ kúrò lọ́dọ̀ mi ẹ oníṣẹ́ ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ẹ bára yín dà sọ́hún
gbọ́dọ̀
pé irú ohun búburú yìí kò ní pọ̀ sẹ́nikẹ́ni
lọ́jọ́
pé ọ̀rọ̀ tá ń tẹnu wọn jáde
that their deceived listeners want to hear
ọ̀rọ̀ tó pẹ́ wọn tí àwọn tó ń gbọ́ wọn láti tàn jẹ tó fẹ́ mọ gbọ́.
Together they shall descend into hell unless they repent.
Àtàwọn tó ń gbọ́ wọn méjèèjì ọgbọ́n lápapọ̀ ọ̀run àpáàdì tara ni àfi tó bá ronú kùwàdà.
I don't follow you to your village.
Àbá lọ sí abúlé rẹ.
I don't follow you to your house.
Mi ò bá yín lọ sí eyín o.
I don't follow you to your district.
Mi ò bá yín lọ sẹ́kùn yín.
I don't follow you to your location.
Mi ò bá yín lọ sí ìletò Ọlọ́run.
But the word of God you have heard here will be following you about.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run tí oníkálukú wa ti gbọ́ yóò máa tọ̀ wá káàkiri lẹ́yìn.
If you do evil,
bó o bá ṣe ibi,
you will hear that voice sounding in your ear.
Ohun Ọlọ́run yẹn yóò máa tọ sọ létí rẹ.
You have been told.
A ti sọ fún ọ.
You have been told.
A sọ fún ọ.
You have been told.
A sọ fún ọ.
But
ṣùgbọ́n
as for me,
nípa tèmi,
how many of you want to follow the Lord?
Àwọn ilé ìlú lè fẹ́ tẹ̀lé Olúwa ń bí.
You know, it's good to follow the Lord.
Ó máa dá láti tẹ̀lé Olúwa.
As for me,
nípa tèmi,
I want to receive grace every day.
Ojoojúmọ́ fẹ́ máa gbọ́ orí ọ̀fẹ́.
Face the temptations every day.
Láti dojúkọ ìdánwò lójoojúmọ́.
And conquer them every day.
Wọ́n ti máa ṣẹ́gun ìdánwò lójoojúmọ́.
Because God is there.
Torí pé Ọlọ́run wà níbẹ̀.
And Christ is available.
Kristi wà lárọ̀ọ́wọ́tò.
And if you are the one,
bó o bá jẹ́ ni
náà, who wants to follow the Lord,
bó o fẹ́ tẹ̀lé Olúwa,
if the devil comes before you 7 ways,
jẹ́ kí èsì wá lọ́nà méje,
he also flees 7 ways.
O yóò sá lọ́nà méje.
But here we are.
Ibi la wà.
We will not stop talking.
Ah, ní dẹ́kun àti mọ sọ.
If I see anything, I may laugh with you now.
Mo lè bẹ̀rẹ̀ rẹ̀
báyìí. Some of us don't understand.
Ohun tí ò yé àwọn kan nìyẹn.
We don't understand leadership.
Mọ ìdáradarí.
We just stop together now.
A jọ sọ̀rọ̀ tán.
And we smile and we talk and we say, my brother, God bless you.
Àárẹ̀ ni mo kí o pẹ̀lẹ́ o mọ̀ kújọ́ mẹ́ta, ṣé àlàáfíà ló wà.
The next hour,
wákàtí tó tẹ̀lé,
you did something.
O ṣe ohun kan tó lòdì.
How is it? You we laugh together. Why don't you want us to tell you this is not right?
Ṣé àjọ rẹ̀ nípa pọ̀ sí kò ìpẹ́ tán. Ó wá sọ ó ṣe. Oh, be ka so fun pe on to se oda.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus gan.
He smiled with Peter.
Ko igba to ba ki se rerin.
Simon.
Simon.
My flesh and blood has not revealed this to
you. Iwo mo jona ki se na ateje lo ki o
ina yo. The spirit of my father has showed you this.
Mi baba mi loke lo
so le. And I say unto you, you are Peter.
Emi wo pe woni
Peter. Upon this rock I will build my
church. Lo da pata ni emi o ko jo mi le lori.
Chapter 15.
Ni orike
orike chapter 16. And then there's a chapter or two after. Peter got carried away. That's what happens to many of us. We get carried away. When they say good things about us, we get carried away. And then Peter said, no, you will not die.
No,
you cannot die now. How can you talk? Just talk, don't talk like that again. That you will die. No. And Jesus turned at him.
Yes, go by. He
said, get thee behind me, Satan.
Father, let him be Satan. Satan.
Satan is on. You said this, Simon. Just now, Peter. Upon this rock, I'll build my church.
And you
turned at him publicly.
And
you call him Satan.
Okweleshu.
I will leave that ministry. That's what many of us will do. Let's be matured. Let's be mature. But by the grace of God, I have cast my lot with the contenders. God be my helper. You people praying for me, I'm going to remain a contender.
Whether
I live here or I go anywhere else, but just keep on praying. I know some of you pray for us, and I appreciate you. I'm glad. But whether you pray or not, I have a duty to pray for myself. I'll remain a contender.
That's what he said.